Welcome to Power Charting. I'm Bruce Fraser, your host. With us today, we have special guest, Alessio Rutigliano. And we are going to cover two really exciting topics together, combined, cryptocurrency and the Wyckoff Method. And fortunately for us, Alessio is one of the foremost people on both cryptocurrency and the Wyckoff Method. And we are very excited to have him here today. Alessio, welcome. Glad you're here.
Hi, Bruce. I'm very pleased to be here today.
So we're very excited to hear your presentation. But first, let's talk about an upcoming event that you have, which is trading the crypto market with the Wyckoff Method, which is a three-part series. Tell us a little bit about it.
Yes, all the technique that we use in the stock market can be successfully applied to Bitcoin and the crypto ecosystem. And so I'm very excited to announce this new course that is totally devoted to crypto trading in July. And I've been preparing this material for a long time. We will cover many strategies for several kinds of traders, from stock investors that want to participate in this new market to conventional ETN to advanced crypto traders. And our goal is to provide a solid framework for both long-term investors and intraday traders.
If you would like to learn more about this three-part series that Alessio is doing, you can go to wyckoffanalytics.com and go right to this page, read more about it, and sign up for it. And so we're very excited. I plan to attend. I'm very excited to hear Alessio's wisdom on crypto and the Wyckoff Method. And if you are a Wyckoffian and have an interest in just becoming more grounded in the Wyckoff Method, I'd like to say that I think you're going to learn a lot from Alessio in applying Wyckoff not to only to crypto, but to markets in general. So consider attending this. Now we're going to take a minute and turn the screen over to Alessio, and then we are going to start his presentation. Alessio has a most impressive blog that he does at wyckoffanalytics.com. Alessio, I love to read your blog, and it's really made crypto interesting to me. Tell us a little bit about it.
Yes, the blog is basically a weekly report on the major cryptocurrencies, and I love the interaction between people and that read the blog, send questions to the Wyckoff Analytics crypto forum. So it's a big community that is just growing. So I'm very pleased to read all the feedback of people, try to give my replies and so on.
And this is available to everybody, so they can go right into your blog page and read all your past blogs there.
Yes, it's totally free.
Wonderful. Well, please present us with your material, and we're really looking forward to hearing more about crypto and Wyckoff.
Yes, and we have also another big announcement. And for the first time, late June, we will host a special conference on Wyckoff and crypto assets. And I will discuss the current market, and we are very honored to have with us Todd Butterfield, the president of the Wyckoff SMI. And Todd has a long experience in the crypto sector and Elliott Waves too. It's a free event, so please join us on our Wyckoff Analytics website.
So June 26th is going to be the online conference, and this is free to all attendees. That's wonderful. We'll be there.
Great. So now let's start our journey into this new asset class. This chart covers almost the whole history of Bitcoin, logarithmic scale. Bitcoin is a good proxy of the speculative sentiment of the market, and very often it works as a leading indicator. From what we have seen these 10 years of history of Bitcoin, the speculation in this sector is strictly related to the aggressive growth of crypto startups that create new tech solutions, especially in the fintech sector. Here we see three major consolidation. In the first consolidation, Bitcoin was still in its infancy. Few market participants, low liquidity. We can see this by the way price moves in those early years. As Wyckoffians, we want to see signs of institutional participation. The second consolidation is much more interesting. Bitcoin was almost in sync with the reaccumulation of the S&P throughout 2015 and 2016, when institutional investors and large companies started to recognize the long-term value of the blockchain industry. The most important platform that will participate in 2016 and 2018 bull market were developed during these crucial years. In this period, institutions, big market players, accumulated Bitcoin in anticipation of higher prices. Almost 3 years of accumulation have produced such a strong uptrend from $200 to $20,000, 100 bigger. Wyckoffians know that time itself is not a good measure of the activity of the CEO. For this reason, we use point and figure charts to measure the cost built in the accumulation range and estimate price projections. And this chart really resonates with my heart because we're using the oldest form of technical analysis to study this new high-tech financial instrument. And the more volatility we have in a range, the higher the target. The volatility throughout this accumulation is very high. For this reason, I've used here percentage scaling. And Bruce has introduced this technique in one of his great webinars on Wyckoff Analytics.
You're too kind.
So it's all your fault, Bruce.
Yes, okay. Well, this is a very exciting chart, and I'm intrigued with your price target.
Great. So in this case, each box represents an increment of 10%. It's a huge percentage. Generally, we use 1% or 3%, but PNF charts are very, very flexible too, and 10% in this highly volatile environment works very well. Look at the aggressive target on the chart, 19,000. It's the 2017 peak. It's really uncanny. Bitcoin was in the headlines in December for the introduction of the futures, a big step for this small ecosystem. And smart money was really happy to take profit after astronomical returns. As usual, when we are looking at this chart in real time, first we want to be able to identify the emergence of the uptrend, and then we want to add to the position on a rising scale. On the vertical chart, this uptrend is so steep that each top looks climatic. Reaccumulation, climatic run. Another accumulation, shakeout, absorption the way up, and so on. How to add here? The point and figure chart offers another trick to conduct our campaign. The purple, red, and green lines on the chart represent segments of the original accumulation area. When we project these partial counts, we get our intermediate targets. Stop, look, and listen. Look at the yellow area. Each time price stops, a new accumulation range forms. Supply is absorbed again, and then the major uptrend continues. And you can use these counts as timing tool. So as you can see, once we adjust our Wyckoffian tools to the specific conditions of volatility and liquidity of this asset class, all the techniques that have been used by generations of traders on stock and commodities work in a canny way. We will see many examples of this throughout the course in July. We have quickly explored the previous market cycle. Now let's see the current consolidation.
Let me just add one thing to that chart,
yes?
Alessio, if you could go back, is just look how exquisitely that trend channel rises up. And there's, as Alessio pointed out, a series of climactic events on the way up. But notice the final climactic event that throws over the top of the channel. And here we can draw trend channels on point and figure. And we can see beautifully, even using 10% scaling, this beautiful throw over of the top of the channel, which is total exhaustion at the final and highest count on the point figure. That's magnificent. So I'm sorry, I just had to say that because it's a great case study.
That's beautiful. And we can see that also on low cap cryptos. So it's not just for Bitcoin. That's a great thing. So what happens after December 2017? At point one, speculators that came late to the party were punished very badly. Hypodermic top. The increase in bearish sentiment during the last week of January 2018 was tremendous. An unstoppable stream of bad news was reported by major newspapers. This is the end of Bitcoin. We are close to February the 6th at point two. February the 6th is not a day like any other in cryptos. The Senate Committee on Banking had a public meeting to discuss the regulations over cryptos. What happens just few hours before the positive outcome of the meeting? The panic selling of those chaotic days was absorbed by big demand coming in. Value buyers see the liquidity and say, 6,000 is our value zone. A wave of short covering comes and price almost doubles in just 2 weeks. Selling climax, automatic rally, secondary test. A trading range starts. We have seen extreme volume in the first part of this chart. Value buyers were extremely active at the beginning of this consolidation. But in the first half of the range, we do not see much institutional participation. Volume decreases. Look at point five and six. Each rally has less and less demand behind it. It's typical of hypodermic tops to be followed by long ranges, especially on commodities or large cap stocks. You can see the same pattern on Microsoft monthly chart, on the chart of gold. And usually in the first half of consolidation, we see this serious lackluster rallies. This pattern simply reflects the fact that momentum traders are not attracted by this instrument by now. Many trend followers that were late to the party and bought near the top had tremendous losses. So in early 2018, the sentiment of the market was still bearish, skepticism was dominant, the economic condition favored other financial instruments, and trend followers were saying, we don't want to be in, at least for now. In this context, price collapses to 3,000, but look at the high volume at 0.7. Someone big is buying again on this bar. In real time, we don't know if this is just temporary buying by mere reversal traders. But after this bar, supply shows evident signs of absorption. We start to suspect that the buying was a systematic, consistent absorption. At 0.8, the up bar shows synchronicity between up effort and up result. This up bar is the confirmation bar. This is our sign of strength bar in the local accumulation structure. So a big rally start, but at 0.9, price commits above the long-term resistance only temporarily, and massive profit taking takes place. At this point, we expect a retest of the support of the big range, but volume on down bars is decreasing. The spreads of the down bars is decreasing as well. Look at 0.10. This is the first sign that selling is exhausted. We are back to the area where momentum to the upside has started and we are seeing signs of absorption. I highlighted this rounding bottom structure. At point 10, supply is very exhausted and you expect a rally to the most significant supply area. If we are able to commit above this supply level, momentum traders will be forced to join the trend on the way up, and this will create a much more significant rally. Bitcoin was performing quite well at the beginning of the COVID crisis, but the margin calls related to the liquidity crash had a significant impact on the crypto ecosystem as well. At point 11, Bitcoin, like gold, became a source of funding, and it was a really tricky spot. But if you have to put this event in the context of the long-term consolidation, what happened next? Price quickly falls at point 12, but value buyers step in again on the same level where we have seen demand in the last years. Shakeout. The subsequent rally shows that quality demand was present. Now we are currently testing this long-term resistance level. Volatility is decreasing this small trading range, and there is still some fuel in the tank to make a high here. If we fail, a crucial level for Bitcoin is the top of the big capitulation bar at point 12. The ability to track different scenarios is very useful when you trade, and market always choose the hardest patterns for traders. But if we are able to follow the story of the market participants, our decisions will be still in line with smart money. What do you think about this chart, Bruce?
Well, it's a beautiful multi-year accumulation type structure that is really just in need of a good sign of strength rally that can show the ability to climb above prior peaks before having some kind of a more maybe backing up action, a pullback, which can demonstrate that accumulation is approaching completion. Looks very promising where it is at point 13.
Yeah. So now let's quickly review the basic of the crypto ecosystem. Bitcoin is often called digital gold. This parallel between gold and Bitcoin is often misleading. I prefer a different analog. Bitcoin is a digital oil. And we want to simplify this concept to traditional investors. In this ecosystem, we have the infrastructure, the blockchain network, the miners, a commodity, Bitcoin, the fuel of this infrastructure. And then there is another important layer in this matryoshka, maybe the most important for speculators. Today, there are thousands of startups that build their own blockchain products or applications, ranging from fintech to supply chains. These companies produce software that runs on the blockchain infrastructure. And since Bitcoin is an open source technology, everyone can potentially copy it and create its own version. As we speak, there are thousands of coders in this industry that pick the original Bitcoin code and work on a new version of the software with a specific goal in mind. For example, there are projects that aim to improve the tracking of supply chains or fintech projects for banks. Since this environment is global and the regulations are still permissive, crypto businesses are able to attract capitals even when they are in the bootstrapping phase. So big players in the industry with thousands of bitcoins reinvest their money in new projects and get crypto tokens, which are the equivalent of shares in the stock market. When the wind is in favor of the whole industry, liquidity generally comes into Bitcoin, and then a part of the profits are directly reinvested in altcoin projects through a tax-free mechanism that favors this kind of rotation. And this chart shows the behavior of the top crypto assets in the previous market cycle. You can see the major consolidations highlighted in yellow. The universe of crypto assets mimics the stock market dynamics. As you can see, when Bitcoin is in a cyclical accumulation, The CEO types in this ecosystem accumulate long-term position in mid and low caps too. And why speculators love these mid and low cap assets? We know that when you get a moving gold and whatever it's being mined, that can produce a high leverage in the gold mining stocks. And Bruce, you have highlighted this during the weekly discussions. So the same leverage mechanism applies to crypto assets. When the price of Bitcoin is in the markup phase, usually small caps tend to outperform Bitcoin. In the past cycle, we have seen astronomical returns in mid caps. In the current cycle, we are seeing the same patterns over and over. So let's say now that we want to campaign these mid and low caps. This is StockChart, and as usual, our analysis starts with a market screener. So lately, StockCharts has included the top 20 crypto assets. That's the big news for us. StockCharts has a phenomenal point of figure engine. So like in the stock market, you compare the asset to the market proxy. In this case, Bitcoin. What do we see on this chart? Chainlink was performing better than Bitcoin throughout 2018. Look at the accumulation base. 1 year in the crypto space can generate very high targets. Chainlink outperformed the market and forms another range at 0.3. The current consolidation show elements of a comparative strength again. And look at that big shakeout at 0.4. That's the COVID reaction. It still creates a high low. Bullish. Quick recovery. And now we want to see if how the consolidation ends. But let's see the horizontal count or the first accumulation range that we have seen Chainlink. One box reversal, user-defined scaling. You can do this on stock charts too. We can clearly recognize the major sign of strength followed by the backing up action. Look at this beautiful count. It's a 10-bagger and it took just 1 month to reach the target. These kind of moves are not uncommon in the crypto space. And we will discuss these up moves on mid caps and micro caps in the second session of the course. And we also want to debunk the urban myth that these kind of assets are a new paradigm for chartists. We have decades of stock charts that behave in the same way, and we will revisit together the analogs between the low cap stocks and crypto markets in our July special.
Isn't it encouraging the way that, say, looking at Chainlink or even looking at Bitcoin, the way that they follow this beautiful Wyckoffian logic to the accumulation structure, and it shows up on these charts in the same way that it shows up in other asset classes, and really demonstrates that this is the human behavior of large and small interests performing to accumulate and distribute shares of the or coins in this case. And so it's very heartening that Wyckoff works so beautifully with this asset.
Yes, I love it. I love it because this technique looks old, but they are so contemporary. No?
Beautiful.
So we have seen these campaigning techniques. But this is a market marked by a strong rotation. Wyckoffians have an edge when it comes to spotting the rotation of institutional capital in any market. And this special will discuss swing intraday trading in the crypto space too.
Fascinating. So, because one thing about thinking about the small crypto assets versus the large ones is that when the speculative interest comes into these smaller cap coins. This is like the gold stocks, the small cap gold stocks. When they start to get speculative interest, that really is actually very healthy for the whole market.
Yes, and the fascinating thing is that we see this kind of leverage effect on this small cap assets. Mm. So it's really, really profitable. So I've published this chart on my last blog. Instead of NASDAQ, S&P, Dow, and Russell, we have crypto indexes. We have Bitcoin, the major assets, then large caps, mid caps, and micro caps. It's extremely important to look at micro caps because they often tend to lead the market. So, point one, Bitcoin institutions take profits. Money rotates into mid caps and micro caps. Point two, micro caps and mid caps start to outperform. Increasing volume micro caps is a sign of institutional interest. Point three, mid caps show selling near the overbought line. On the micro caps index, supply is quickly absorbed on the way up. Outperformance. Point four, climactic move on the microcaps index. Bitcoin large cap indexes laggards falls to the oversold line, but volume is relatively low. And we are currently consolidating. So we want to see a consolidation in the lead index. This chart is not updated. Bitcoin today has experienced a potential phase C, but it must keep its gain to confirm a potential accumulation structure. So one of the most frequently asked questions on our Wyckoff Analytics blog regards the selection process. Here we see three charts. Bitcoin at the top, large cap altcoins, and mid caps on the bottom. As you can see, these three instruments show a very strong correlation. On a comparative basis, however, the mid cap index is already clearing the resistance. We look for a candidate long side within this index. Here's the list of crypto assets that composes the mid-cap index. Tezos, Cardano, and Chainlink are popular cryptos. Let's pick Cardano, ADA on the ticker, for our case study. On the daily chart, both assets have decreased volatility, but Cardano shows a flat consolidation and a high high compared to Bitcoin. This is a very interesting structure. So let's analyze Cardano on the 4-hour chart. The chain. Okay, great. The change of character is very small, a first bullish clue. In the middle of consolidation, we see high effort to downside but low result, and price quickly comes back to the range. Multiple tests warn us that supply is exhausted and an uptrend starts. Price commits above the resistance and then consolidate in the top half of the range. Last point of support. The bars highlighted in yellow offers a good point of entry. And we can jump directly to this chart to see the after of this. And as you can see, an accurate selection is always the key to improve your performance in such a volatile environment. And that's it for today.
Alessio, oh my gosh, how great it is that you have joined us. People, don't be discouraged that we had to end here, because we're going to have Alessio back over and over again to talk about these cryptocurrency markets. And Alessio, I want to really encourage everyone to attend your conference that you have coming up, and also to attend your 3-part workshop, which I think is going to be phenomenal. And I intend to attend both of those. So any final thoughts before we conclude?
Well, I hope to see you again in July, and it was a big, big pleasure for me.
Oh gosh, thank you for being here. And we'll have you back soon. Thank you.
Thank you, Bruce.
Hey guys, Grayson Rose here with StockCharts.com. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Remember, if you did, give us a like down below, leave us a comment, we'd love to hear from you, and most importantly, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel for daily content from an incredible collection.